With the Enterprise Data and Analytics team. Today I'm going to show you how to use Microsoft Excel 2016 for Mac to connect to SQL Server and issue a query. First we need to open Microsoft Excel, and if you have the version 2011, you're going to need to upgrade to 2016 to do this. 2011 didn't come bundled with the ODBC driver that we need. But once you get Excel open, we need to go to the Data tab, and we're going to go to New Database Query. Then we're going to select SQL Server ODBC. It wants to know where we're connecting, and it wants to know what database. Database is optional. If you don't specify one, it'll give you a list of databases. Next, we need to change our authentication method to Kerberos. Now, Kerberos is going to query the NetID domain and get a ticket for you so that you're trusted when you connect to the SQL Server. It wants your NetID, but it wants it in a very particular format. It's much more like an email format. So you want your username at netid.washington.edu and then your regular NetID password. Some of you may be used to doing netid slash your username. That will fail if you try to authenticate here with that. So once you're successful, you should have a Kerberos ID. And in fact, if you want to check on your ID, Mac has an application called Ticket Viewer that you can create and remove IDs. So we're going to go ahead and hit connect. And so now we've connected to EDW Pub, and we've got this list of databases. And I'm going to take a quick look at budget activity detail by name 2011. And I'm only going to grab the top 10. One of the issues that we'll run into is that the Microsoft query will only show tables. It won't show views, which means that all of our sec views are hidden. You can type anything you like into the SQL statement, but you won't be able to use this little user interface to select sec views. But I'm going to run it. I got my 10 results, and I'm going to return that data to Excel. Excel wants to know where to put that data, so I'm just going to tell it the existing sheet. And we should have our data returned to us. So if you have Excel 2016 for Mac, and if you authenticate with a Kerberos ticket, you should be good to go. So this has been Michael Takos with the Enterprise Data and Analytics team. We've got more videos and more helpful tips and tricks on our website.